A fully stacked Starship is still set to conduct the next round of tests for its fully reusable launch system ahead of its debut orbital launch attempts, as soon as later this year. This is despite a surprise destack of Ship 24 on Sunday, although this does not preclude restacking ahead of the next phase of resting, during the coming week. The new round of launch readiness testing kicked off in earnest, with the stacking of Booster 7 onto the Orbital Launch Mount on Monday, October 10. This was followed on October 12 by stacking Ship 24, on top of the Super Heavy Booster, ahead of what was anticipated to be a battery of fueling tests, to prepare for a static fire test series of the booster's 33 Raptor 2 engines. However, stacking operations did not go entirely to plan, with observers noting a shift in the booster as Ship 24 was placed atop it. The fact that there was an issue was confirmed the following day, October 13, when SpaceX workers performed a partial destack of the rocket and sent workers up the tower. Across the quick disconnect arm, and up in lifts to perform visual inspections, before lowering Ship 24 back down onto the booster. Interestingly, the first two full stacks for Starship in February and March 2022, did not result in the same observed shift of that booster, as a ship was placed on top of it. The fact that this was seen for the first time, on the third stacking could point to iterative design changes on the booster, ship, and ohm after the prior stacking in March. Those changes could be exacerbating factors to the issue observed Monday. Indeed, sources noted that additional work was now required, on the ground support equipment, and pad through the weekend and into the start of the new week. Nevertheless, the issue did not initially appear to be overtly severe, given that SpaceX did not immediately destack the vehicles, Wednesday night and that they immediately restacked them Thursday after visual inspections. Moreover, the vehicle had remained stacked through the weekend, until Sunday at least when Ship 24 was separated from Booster 7. No specific reason has yet been provided for this operation. Elon Musk said, "We are proceeding very carefully. If there is a rut on the pad, Starship progress will be set back by approximately 6 months. Issues in general are expected during initial test campaigns, especially ones attempting to place the most powerful rocket ever created into orbit, under its own brand new propulsion systems." SpaceX is not the only large aerospace organization facing issues, and delays getting a brand new Super Heavy lift rocket off the ground. Both NASA and Blue Origin are likewise working issues, some more significant than others, with SLS and New Glenn, respectively. To this, Starship and its complexity are no different. Despite Sunday's destack, sources note that the current plan for the week of October 17th, is to complete pad and GSE work and then aim for full cryogenic wet dress rehearsal. A sign this is still the plan will be visually confirmed via a restack of Ship 24. This will include a countdown that stops short of igniting engines on Booster 7 by mid to late week. Moreover, the fueling test will also be a critical moment for the quick disconnect arm, that has never been used to cryogenically fuel a ship to date. Verifying its complete operational status is key to continuing with the remaining test sequence. Additionally, SpaceX could seek to repeat the fueling test to gain as much data as possible, before proceeding into a multi-step static fire campaign. For the currently understood plan, SpaceX will first attempt to static fire a subset of the engines on Booster 7, before proceeding incrementally up from there to ultimately firing all 33 engines, at the same time. If the full-stack cryogenic test goes well this coming week, a static fire could follow as soon as a few days thereafter. The ultimate plan of firing all 33 engines will help verify computational fluid dynamics calculations, of what the exhaust environment will be like, what it will do, and where it will go. The tests will also validate the modeling of the acoustic environment all 33 Raptor 2 engine will unleash and how well the sound suppression system, now installed at the orbital launch mount, will be in deadening enough of the sound to allow for safe operations of the system. Moreover, full-stack static fires provide multiple opportunities to fully fuel Ship 24, and observe how well its thermal protection system tiles stay attached, during engine start and firing. This is to say there is still a long road ahead for Starship, before it can make its opening launch attempt. Most recent comments by Elon Musk indicate a late November target, by the founder and chief engineer for SpaceX. However, given the natural stretch to test schedules, and the need to stop and address issues that are discovered, a more realistic launch period is likely in the December 2022, to February 2023 timeframe at present. Starship gets another mission. Another major step for the overall Starship program came on October 12, when SpaceX announced the first two passengers who bought tickets on Starship's second circumlunar navigation flight. Exactly when this fight will take place is an open question, as it is dependent on its Dear Moon predecessor, and the Starship program's larger commitments to NASA's Artemis program. Both of which will follow numerous planned Starlink and fuel depot test flights to prove out the overall system. The first two passengers for this second lunar flyby mission are Dennis and Akiko Tito. Dennis Tito was the first private astronaut space tourists, when he paid for a seat on the Russian Soyuz, for a week-long flight to the International Space Station in the space world. Dennis earned a Bachelor of Science in Aeronautics and Astronautics degree, in 1962, and a Master of Science in Engineering Science degree in 1964. He worked for NASA at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, in the 1960s, in part as a trajectory design engineer on the Mariner 4 mission, the first to return close-up images of Mars. Dennis Tito is 82 years old and would stand to be the oldest person to launch into Earth orbit, should the mission and his participation in it take place. Regarding his age, Tito stated to NASA Spaceflight in a one-on-one interview after the announcement that, there was that question 21 years ago. NASA was very concerned about my age, and I was put through a lot of medical tests. Then it came to now, this mission, and it's an even bigger issue because I'm 82 years old now. To this end, the Titos will be heavily monitored on the flight from a medical perspective. We are going to be very carefully monitored, especially myself, given my age. And the monitoring should contribute a lot to medical knowledge. And we will need that once we're ready to send Starship to Mars, with as many as 100 people for a 9-month flight, you need to really understand the physiology, particularly a whole wide range of ages. Joining him on the flight is the so far only other announced passenger is Akiko Tito, a system engineer and jet-rated commercial pilot. Although NASA has been clear that a woman will be part of the Artemis 3 landing team, Akiko is the first named woman to be announced to travel to the moon, though she will not be the first to ultimately do so. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.